Busy weekend over the weekend, as all of our weekends are. Everybody's busy all the time, it seems like now. But over the weekend, I had the opportunity to see Frozen Junior by the Chesapeake Public Charter School. The kids there did a great job with it. The villain was phenomenal. It was a good production. My whole family enjoyed it. And I also had the opportunity, it was very much a theater weekend. I got to see Sherwood, The Adventures of Robin Hood by the Newtown Players. They did a great job too. It was a fun show and pretty funny. Coming up this coming weekend is the Southern Maryland Spring Festival. It'll be at the county fairgrounds from Thursday through Sunday. It'll be a great time, beautiful weather, great chance to get out and enjoy it. And then Saturday will be the season finale for the Cosmic Symphony. They're going to be doing Sounds of the Screen, so it'll be a lot of movie music, so from Titanic, Pirates of the Caribbean, James Bond. And, of course, since it's May the 4th, there'll be some Star Wars music. It'll be a fun time. Saturday, May 4th, 3 p.m. at the Dodge Performing Arts Center at St. Mary's College. It's a free concert. You will not be disappointed. Come check it out. They do a really, really good job. Also, happening tonight, there's an election going on in Leonardtown, and tonight the Leonardtown Business Association, who was here with us earlier this morning for Small Business Month, will be hosting a candidate forum at the Rex, so go check that out. If you're a Leonardtown resident, you can just hear from the mayor candidates and the town council people who are up for re-election, just hear their thoughts and what's going on there. And then briefly want to touch on some of the business we did today. We had our legislative wrap-up, and we got to hear from our, how did Mr. Hauser call him, our government relations specialist, our lobbyist that we hired. We hired him for $15,000. It was a controversial decision that we took some flack for. And yesterday, Maryland Matters, which is an online news reporting agency dealing with Maryland state news, they had a wrap-up on lobbying this past session in the General Assembly. They pointed out that there was 701 registered lobbyists, 1,500 businesses spent $77.6 million on lobbyists in this General Assembly session, 539 businesses, trade groups, unions, and associations that spent at least $50,000 on lobbyists. That's what we're up against here. That's who's influencing the legislators in Annapolis. And so having another tool in our tool belt to help our delegation, to help our county represent the best interests of St. Mary's County is important. And it paid off. We got to hear the report, the wrap-up, with a lot of good information. The golf cart bill that we have been pushing for years came out in a better version than what we proposed. We proposed one that was limited to certain neighborhoods. Instead, we ended up with a statewide one that gives us blanket authority to assign them wherever we want in the county on county roadways. It's a better bill partially because of the help from our lobbyists and our delegation working together. And then one of the biggest things that we discussed earlier is the Pascal Crisis Stabilization Center coming to St. Mary's County. Through significant grants from the state level, this is a huge win for our county, for mental health. It's going to help the whole region, but it's something that this board and the previous board has really hit on a lot, is trying to get help when we see the suicides happening off the Thomas Johnson Bridge. This is a facility that will provide crisis stabilization for people dealing with addiction, PTSD, all kinds of issues, mental health issues, a facility they can go and stay in 4 to 10 days or longer if necessary to be able to get the help that they need. And this is a really good thing. So I'm excited about that and excited to see it move forward. So with that, thank you very much.